Day three of Boise State basketball, and that means we've reached Iowa's biggest schools. Also, a showcase for many future Division I players. We welcome Mark Freund live at Wells Fargo Arena. Mark, many fans have looked forward to seeing these guys play on the big stage.
Yeah, Keith, there certainly is no shortage of talent in Class 4A, and the standard of talent really is Waukee. The Warriors have four future Division I players in their starting five, but somehow Waukee is not the top seed in Class 4A. That would be Cedar Falls. Waukee instead the two seed and fired up for their first round game against seventh seeded Pleasant Valley. And the Warriors looked like a motivated group, wasting no time. Tucker DeVries from distance. Waukee is off and running. A bit later, DeVries passes up the shot and passes it off to Peyton Sanford for the layup. Waukee up 13-0, and you can see where this is going. No letting up. Warriors work it around the horn to Sanford again. He leads the way with 18. Second quarter, another Sanford. This time it's Price cashing in on a triple. That puts Waukee up 22 points. They win by 22, 65-43. Impressive showing to start the tournament.
This is the best time of year. Yeah, this is, and there's no better place to be with that group than down here. So I was really impressed with their maturity, just their focus today. I felt like we were ready. We didn't need to get them too locked in. They were ready to go on their own.
We do have a lot of proof, but I mean, we have a lot of proof for ourselves, and we're going to do that as a team, and we're going to show that every night.
It's just fun to be here. I feel like a lot of our guys are at our best when we're here, so that experience is crucial. When we're playing together, we're having fun out there and we're playing free, we can beat anybody on any given day.
Let's get another quarterfinal. It's Taman Lipsey and Ames taking on Council Bluffs Abraham Lincoln. End of the first, Lipsey gets wild, loose ball, but it kicks out to Keyshawn Brooks. He beats the horn with a three ball. And Ames keeps it rolling. Second quarter, open look for Casey Mum for three. Bang it home. Little Cyclones up six at the half. Second half, they break it open. Here's Lipsey on the drive. He finishes. Taman had 12 points on the day. And a fellow junior, Corey Phillips, notched a team high 16. Phillips for three. Ames wins 54-37. When Lipsey and Phillips were freshmen, they lost in the first round. Little Cyclones don't lose this time.
We were super motivated. You know, we just didn't want to feel that feeling again. So we knew we had to come out here and get the job done. And that's what we did.
We all played a lot our freshman year. And we didn't have the result we wanted to. And we've grown a lot since then. So we knew that we can go farther, and that's what we're here to do.
You have that experience of being here, that's great, but you come back again, you certainly want to start winning games here, and that's the feeling I got. I didn't think there was any revenge or do better this time, just a comfort level, a confidence level.
So it'll be Ames versus Waukee in the 4A semifinals coming up tomorrow. No shortage of offense in that matchup, at least on paper. Keith, it also guarantees we will have a Central Iowa team in the 4A state championship. Should be fun.
Imagine that. The 4-5 matchup, Johnston taking on Dowling Catholic. Now, these teams split 1-1 in the regular season, but this game was all Dragons. And really, it was all Stephen Kramer. Kramer working inside, gets the hook to go. Johnston already up nine. Kramer's not done. Airborne off the inbound play, throws it down. Kramer with a big game, 16 points. Dowling down double digits, but doing its best to stay in it. Matthew Riedel to the cup. Maroons back within nine, but a bit later off the steal. Trey Lewis lays it in. Johnston goes back up double digits, doesn't look back. Dragons win 49-33. They advance to the 4A semifinals.
We kind of had like a little rough game against them last time, and they were talking, so we were excited to get that one back for sure.
We weren't playing our best basketball at the beginning, but I'll give credit to them. They were playing well, but just disappointed we didn't get a show. All the effort we put in practice and stuff throughout the year, I don't think we played to our best today.
I'm proud of our guys for finding a way to get down here, and even more proud of them for finding a way to win today against a really good Dowling team. So we'll enjoy it a little bit today, and then you have to get ready for a really good team, whoever we're going to play tomorrow. Everybody that makes it down here is a good team, so we'll have to be ready to go, and I'm excited for the opportunity.